To be a student athlete is to be the ultimate student ambassador for your university. You're going to represent a part of Howard for the rest of your life. So you have to wear that with a badge of honor. You know what I mean? You have to have some pride about that. Student athletes value, you could put no monetary dollar on it. You know, let's remember something. There is no better way to showcase, expose, market, or brand an institution of higher education than a vibrant, rules-abiding, competitive athletic program. And there is no entity of an institution that can do that better than an athletic program.
My name is Kyle Riley, from Indianapolis, Indiana, and I play basketball. To be a student athlete is to be prioritized, to be hardworking, and to be efficient.
Imagine having a job in addition to school. Whoever has a job on top of their schoolwork can equate it with being an athlete and going to school at the same time.
It's more of a full-time job as opposed to a privilege. There's different aspects. We work out about 3 times a day, and 4 if you have, Howard has a swimming class, so a lot of my teammates actually have the 4 workouts a day. And then you add study hall, and you have to take a certain amount of credits, and you have to get a certain GPA, I think it's 2.0, just to be able to be eligible.
It's something that not everybody can do, and it's only a select few that can probably make it through being a student athlete in college. We're doing everything that a regular student does, which is keeping up your grades, maintaining a certain GPA, and being respectful in the classroom, all the things that a regular student has to do. But then on top of that, we also have to maintain our physical features or anything that pertains to being on the field or in the courts or whatever you do as a student athlete.
I come from a tennis family, so 6 of the 7 of us play tennis. And my dad liked tennis a lot, so he got us all involved so we could get tennis scholarships. And so I started when I was 7. And initially I went to Georgetown University for college, but I didn't like it. And I played on the team there for Big East, but transferred to Howard University, and I've been here for 2 years.
Well, I went to Presbyterian College, and they play in the same conference as Howard. And I ran into Desiree Cox, who plays with me. She's my teammate, my roommate. And when I was there, I ended up playing against Desiree, and I love seeing her. It was great to see her, and well, I was unhappy at my last school, and so I was looking for new places to go, and I just remembered, you know, meeting her and how happy she seemed at Howard, and I wanted to be that happy. Transferring, you're not allowed, you have to sit out a season. So you're doing all the workouts and you're putting in all the effort, but you're not getting the reward of playing. And so it's kind of hard watching all your friends go out there and get to play and not be able to be with them. It's not fun. It's definitely not fun. And it's also when you see, when you want to be able to help as well, and you want to be there because you practice with these kids every day. Like, we all practice together every day, so we all depend on each other. And in school, and on the field, we're all a unit. So when one member, whether it's me or whether it's, you know, anyone sitting on the sideline, it's like you're losing a piece of the puzzle. And so it's hard for me, it's hard for the team, it's kind of hard for everyone. But I don't mind being the team cheerleader. I kind of like it. It's nice to be able to at least be there. And I love my team. They're fantastic. I love them.
Well, as a football player, training for me isn't easy, of course. You know, you get out what you put in. So it's something like, let's say a Monday, we're waking up at 5:30, we have running from 6 to 7.
I wake up at 5 a.m., about 5:10, kind of cut it close.
Wake up, sometimes we have morning workouts.
And then I usually have class at 10.
Get something to eat in between.
I go back to the second class.
Go back to class.
And then after that, you have a mandatory workout.
Then I go work out with Coach D.
Hopefully take a shower somewhere in between there.
You might have practice in the afternoon or evenings.
Hopefully eat somewhere in between there too, but I can't guarantee that.
We have practice at night, and we have to leave at 8:30, and we don't usually get back till about 11:30.
And then on Saturdays, we practice at 7 a.m. Instead of 6, so.
I was expecting said that I have something wrong with my cartilage in my wrist, and I have to get a wrist
scan. What are you doing at?
They said my appointment's not until the 22nd.
I actually had a shoulder injury 2 years ago, freshman year, and then it moved to my elbow and then to my wrist, and now it's kind of reverting back in the reverse way. So currently I have tendonitis, so I go to rehab after I work out, and it's usually a band workout, or I have to ice it for 20 minutes, take it off for 20 minutes, ice it again. And so that's on top of everything else that I already have in order to cure my wrist.
Getting back on the field, court of play, is the biggest component to being a student athlete. Because at some time or another, it's hard to say you can go through 4 years of college without having a nick. Or shoot, I've never seen so many. Yeah, two guys pull tore ACLs in basketball my first month here. That's a part of the game. It's an unfortunate part, but I think the most important thing is how fast we can get you back.
I had a back injury. I had a bad disc in my back. I'm still currently suffering from it. Took me out of half of my freshman year, just rehabbing and stuff like that. Played my whole sophomore year, and then caused some problems last year as well, my junior year. Just kind of been battling through it this senior year, you know, just because it's my last go around. So unfortunately, it caused a little bit of controversy with my whole college career. You know what I mean?
Injuries is always a thing that nobody wants to deal with. It's a setback, and it's just maybe a whole year lost.
It just makes it a lot more. It makes them a lot harder because you're battling your own issues, and then you're on top of that, you're trying to get back in shape. And that's what's the worst part, is that when you get injured, every athlete, when they get injured, you're not really that, I personally am not really that mad about the injury, but it's knowing how awful it's going to be trying to get back to that level, because you're working out at such a high level that anything that disrupts that, it sets you back like a month, it sets you back a month and a half.
The faster and sooner a student athlete can get back to the respective sport is good, and as you mentioned, class, if you have surgery, you're gonna miss some class. Rehab time, you could miss some class. So, as we said before, you gotta be balanced. You have to be thinking ahead, because there are some classes you're gonna miss.
Well, the thing about traveling is that you have to leave. Well, sometimes you have to leave early from your classes, or you're not able to go to classes because, say you have a class at 10 and your leave time's 9 o'clock, you have to get permission from your teachers, or even sometimes take a test early or have class or turn in your homework early.
I don't get the same knowledge that everybody learned on a Friday when I was gone. So when I come back, a lot of times I'm not prepared for the quizzes like everybody else is, or I don't have all the notes and I don't have the time because I'm gone the whole weekend to get those notes from another student.
It's tough because, as I mentioned before, you do miss class, so you have to catch up in your classes, getting notes from your classmates and meeting up with teachers when you get back, finding out what you missed.
And then on top of that, you have to go away for a weekend, practice, all the time that people have for their leisure time or their downtime for the week. That's when you're working hard, and then you get back Sunday night or something and you're starting your school week all over again.
But you just gotta learn to deal with it, and you just gotta put in the extra work to pass the class.
It can be a disadvantage, so, but on the road we have study halls as well, in the lobbies or in a room. They make sure they find a place for us to make sure that we're staying on top of our work.
You definitely have to study harder and longer, and your spare time is spent studying, so I definitely have no room to slack.
The student athletes who come here are honestly dedicated to academics first. Now, with the rigorous schedules we just talked about, it means you're going to miss some class. But most importantly, without a shadow of doubt, our student athletes are here for an education. I think you have to really embrace the challenge and the pressure. You have to be one of those type people. You know, you have to have suitiveness, you have to have drive, you have to really, really embrace and love the challenge. And I think that's why so many of the student athletes at Howard are so successful after they complete their degree.
My experience has been pretty good, and I've enjoyed every step of it because I've actually seen myself grow.
You work so hard just so you can get that 60 minutes where in those 60 minutes you get that ball and you feel invincible, where nothing in the world affects you. You don't care about the people that are screaming your name. That's not what you focus on. You focus on that freedom and the excitement and the competition, that the adrenaline rush. Like that's the big stuff. That's the important stuff.
I don't know if there's anything outside of school that's stressful or anything. I'll just, tennis is the time to let the stress go. We're not only playing tennis, we're playing for Howard. We're Howard's tennis team, and it's always nice to feel that you're a part of Howard's community.
It's a surreal experience, especially here, you know, because I personally feel like there's really no place like, you know, the Burr, you know, when it's a full house and everybody's there supporting and cheering, the band's going and everybody's rocking. Like, there's nothing like it. You know, I really enjoy playing here, and it's something that I'll take on with me for the rest of my life. So, you know, I cherish it. I cherish it, being a student athlete, and, you know, it's taught me a lot of things. So I definitely don't take it for granted, and I wouldn't have it any other way.